Did you know that there are people making millions of dollars selling online products? And if you're thinking about selling online products, you're in luck because all you need to get started is a computer and Wi-Fi connection. I'm Bruno Cimeiro. In this video, we're going to talk about how to sell online products. Whether you're just starting out and want to find the best way to sell your online products, or maybe you've been trying to sell online products for a while, but the results are bad. Either way, I really hope that this video will help you find the answer that you're looking for. Now, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel so you don't miss anything when I come up with new content. And while you're watching, let me know what kind of online products you want to sell and what are some of the challenges that comes with it in the comment section below. It might be something that I can really help you with. And hey, make sure you stick until the end of this video because I'm gonna show you a way to sell online products without a product of your own. Meaning, no dealing with customer support, handle payment, nor having a particular skill or experience. Keep watching. Now, for those who don't know, online products, in other words, digital products, are media that can be distributed repeatedly online without the need to manage physical inventory or physical store. These products are often delivered in downloadable formats such as PDF, audio, video, software, or templates. Here are some of the benefits of selling online products. First, it saves you time and money. When selling digital product, you don't need to handle inventory, shipping, nor paying for sourcing and storing. Second, it is scalable. Digital products are infinitely scalable because your audience is global. It also offers high profit margin. Besides the sales of your online product, the money that you would use to purchase and manage physical inventory will increase your profit margins. You've got also the potential to automation. It is relatively easy to automate digital product delivery. That way you could work on other ways to grow and expand your business. It also offers flexibility. At any point, you can create new products or change the way you sell your product. Now that you know the benefit of selling online products, let's see what kind of online products you can sell. 1. Educational product. If you consider yourself an expert on a particular topic, digital products are a great way to package that information and sell it to others looking to learn. You can leverage an existing reputation as an expert to get attention for your product. Or if you're just starting from scratch, you can create and give away free content to generate interest and leads for your paid digital products. 2. License to use your digital asset. From stock photos to video footage, from music and sound effects, there is a global ecosystem of licensable digital assets uploaded by creatives for artists creative to use in their work. By offering license to individual and business, you can charge for the use of your photos, video, music, software, and templates in your own store and through online marketplace. 3. Membership sites. Instead of selling individual digital products, you can bundle them together and lock them behind a paid subscription to generate recurring revenue. This approach is ideal if you plan to maintain and grow a library of premium content and nurture a community of passionate members. In some cases, paid digital subscription can even create an opportunity to directly monetize your existing content marketing effort. The 4th one is digital templates and tools. Digital products can also come in the form of intangible tools that equip a professional to do tasks that either fall outside of their skill set or take up a lot of time. You can sell digital solutions to the common pain points and needs of a specific audience. Some examples include digital marketing strategy templates for entrepreneurs, mobile apps for business, graphic design templates for posters, etc. If you already have a freelance business, it might be worth considering how you can turn your skills and service into digital products to create a passive stream of revenue. Now, how do you create digital products? Finding a good business idea is more of a process. It is great to have an idea that excites you, but if you want an idea that sells, you want to follow a process of brainstorming, researching, and validation. How about brainstorming? Write down all the ideas that you would like to turn into a business. Even if you think it is a bad one, the thing is, don't be critical. With the following step that I'm about to show you, it may turn out to be a profitable idea. Who knows? If you're looking for a spark, you should consider asking yourself some questions like, can I teach customers how to use my product? Are there things I can help my customers with related to my overall industry? What are some of the values I've built my business on? And what are the topics related to them? In what ways could I bring my community of customers together? Last but not least, What am I good at? Those questions will help you get a clearer idea of what kind of online products you want to sell. Next, you want to do some research to add it to your list of business ideas. Look for pain points your customers have related to your product, industry, or value, as well as a topic they love or get excited about. Here are some of good places to get started doing research. First, Facebook groups. There are Facebook groups dedicated to every niche and audience imaginable, making them a good place to learn what your potential customers care about. Also, industry forums. Forums dedicated to hubs and a community in your industry can help you learn more about what people want and need in your broader industry. Now, about validation. Before committing too much time to an idea, you want to validate it and make sure it is a solid one. The last thing you want to do is invest a lot of time and money in a new venture without knowing it has a good chance to be successful. There are a couple of ways to validate your idea. You can do keyword research, you know, use a keyword tools to see how many people are searching for your topic. This will give you an idea of the opportunity size of each one. You can also use Google Trends. Search your topics on Google Trends, look for topics that are growing in interest. No matter what industry you're in, you're having a unique strength and knowledge that would be valuable to your customer. Now about the main question of this video, how to sell online products. Whether you're a brand new business owner or adding digital product to your existing store, keep these tips in mind. First, create a great product. The first criteria for creating digital products is to add value to your customer's life. Second, promote a lead magnet. Regardless of how much your product costs, create a light version of it for free. A free product can help you build an email list you can sell to in the future. Third, collect pre-orders. A great way to get early sales is by giving a discounted early bird price. If you're releasing a new digital product, you can offer a 50% discount for the first 100 buyers, then 25% for the next 100 buyers, and so on. And fourth, offer a money-back guarantee. If you're hesitant about offering warranty on your product, it makes sense. Some people could buy and use your product, then ask for their money back. But it is all a part of running an online business. The rewards of high conversion rates outweigh the small percentage of people who may abuse the policy. A money-back guarantee shows potential buyers that you're putting your money where your mouth is and putting the risk on you, not them. Now, at the beginning of this video, I told you that I would show you a way to sell online products without you having to create your own product, and that is through affiliate marketing. Affiliates are a huge source of traffic and sales for creators selling digital products. You can be an influencer who are established and trusted in your industry and get a commission for each sales you make from somebody else's product. So if you're somebody who has a massive audience, you can get a higher commission rate for promoting more and attract customers. So what is the number one takeaway you got from this video? Let me know by leaving a quick comment below. And if you like this video, leave some thumbs up. Now, if you're enjoying this video and you want to learn more about ways to sell online products, you know, somebody else's products, by becoming an affiliate and reap all the benefits that comes with it, such as not having your own products, no need for experience or skills, just click the first link right below this video. It is going to lead you to a free online training where you will learn all the process of selling online products and much, much more. I really hope that you got some value from this video. Okay, see you. Take care.